Cool, man. I wanted to go through your breakdown with you.
The weekly
one? The weekly one, yeah, so.
I think it was Cody and somebody else did.
Cody and Jasmine,
like,
yeah.
I got a bit lost because I was like, oh, like, I wasn't too sure if it was just meant to be like a dot point thing or it was meant to be like a daily breakdown but bigger or like, so I wasn't too sure what to.
Yeah, so it's kind of like a daily breakdown but bigger.
Yeah.
So you can see that the guys is like really breaking down their performance in the field. Yeah, so it's like, they're not just in the hamster wheel of, oh, well, hopefully we do more sales this week.
Yeah.
Like, they're thinking about it, they're breaking it down, they're trying to dissect their KPIs, they're trying to identify strengths and weaknesses and what's going well, what's going not so well.
Yeah.
You know, even comments about, like, you know, personal stuff that, you know, probably caused her to be sick, which sort of flew, like, had a flow-on effect, sorry, to her performance in the field and her organization for the week and stuff like that. Her goals were the really cool thing about her breakdown. It's, like, really detailed.
Yeah.
And they're really specific. We're talking about SMART goals. You know, specific is the S. You know, she's got a number attached to every single goal, which is essentially how you make a goal specific. You attach a number or a metric to it.
Okay, right.
So it's like, she wants to do exactly 3 teachable videos. She wants to run 1 impact in a prime time. She wants to do 15 sales. She wants to do 12 closes per day as a minimum. Get 15 stops per day as a minimum. 3 sales a day as a minimum. Like, she's got all these little targets that she's working towards.
Yeah, right.
So it's no surprise as to why you'll notice, you know, people like Jazz and Cody, like, they're just constantly getting better.
Yeah.
Because they just put a lot of effort, a lot of reflection time into how they're going, why they're doing, you know, well or not so well, why that they think that might be the case.
Yeah.
This is like a really good start.
Yeah.
I'd probably add, you've been around long enough to kind of understand all the numbers, so I would add in bonuses, hours.
Yeah.
Some of the guys will even do like a day by day kind of breakdown.
Yeah.
Like, they'll have their totals for the week.
Oh yeah.
That's his average per day. But then that's also every day for the week as well. Right. So I can see how the day kind of.
Yeah, right.
You know, sometimes the average might look really good. But you might have had a couple of days in there that you kind of pied it.
Yeah, yeah.
So having it all written out like that, it's just really easy to see and you can comment on it a bit easier. Like, I started the week real shit, but I finished quite well. So my averages look good, but I did pie the Monday.
Yeah.
You know, which isn't the case here, but
you can
see trends like that. So I like this. I like the 8 sales for the week, like, really tangible number. 1 video on teachable per night. You know, trying to stop everyone I see. That's probably a little vague. You know, you want to try and attach a number to every single goal because that way you know it's specific.
Yeah.
So instead of trying to stop everyone I see, give yourself an actual number, like minimum 15 stops per day or minimum 12 stops per day or have a day where I stop 25 people.
Yeah.
Because at least then at the end of the week, you can literally tick it and say, yes, I achieved that goal, or you can give it a cross and go, I didn't achieve that goal.
Yeah.
Whereas trying to stop everyone I see, at the end of the week, looking back, how do you tick that off? It's like, oh, I think I tried to stop everyone I saw. It's kind of hard to measure it, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of a bit of an ambiguous, vague kind of goal.
Yeah.
So if you attach a number to it, it just makes it really black and white. It's like you either, achieved it or didn't. Okay. And you notice the guys that have been around longer, all of their goals have numbers attached to it.
This is all so new to me. I never write goals, so I don't even know what, like, a vague goal is, because when I wrote it, I was just like, yeah, all right, by the end of the week, I'll be like, all right, I kind of did it, rather than, like, there's a number there.
Yeah.
If I met the number, then I did it, but if I don't meet the number, then I didn't do it.
Mm.
So, all a bit of a learning curve. But
obviously,
now seeing other breakdowns, like, I now know what to do, kind of thing.
Yeah, for sure.
Rather than just, like, slapping it all together.
So does that kind of make sense in terms of what a weekly breakdown should look like?
Yeah, 100%, definitely.
Cool, man, I like it. How are you going with Teachable? Have you done a few more videos on that?
Yeah, I have done a few more videos.
Do you want to pull it up for me?
No, it's all getting there.
Yeah, so-